about it, because I have a belief, I do believe God, you know, so that's my belief. But I talked to him about it, and the thought to write a book came. And so I said, well, what am I going to write about, Lord? You know, we always ask when thoughts come, what am I going to do? What's the next step? So he said, well, you're already writing inspirational quotes to yourself. Why not write them for everyone else? So I said, all right. And they just started coming like a flood, literally, like a flood. First, the title came. I said, well, what am I going to name it? So I said, you know, you want to be inspirational. So get inspired, stay inspired, start inspiring. So I'm like, all right. I will write quotes to help people get inspired, because we need to get there. Like, it's rough getting there. To even get inspired is a little rough. You know, so I said, most importantly, once we get there, we need to stay there. We gotta stay there. And that's hard too. Because we get there, but then we lose focus and we're back to square one, you know? So I said, once we get there, once we stay there, what's the most important thing? And to me, it's inspiring others. So that's why I wrote Start Inspiring, because we have to start inspiring ourselves and others. Mm-hmm. And what other way to do it? So that's how my book came about, and that's really the most important thing that I want everyone to take from my book, is that we need to start helping each other. You know, that's one thing that we lack as a human being. You know, we always want to be for self, which is a sad, sad thing, but once we start to share ourselves with others, they may realize that they may want to share themselves with others too, and they may want to start inspiring as well. So once we take that step and that leap, remember, there's always people watching you. It could be your nephew, your niece, your sister, your best friend, your coworker. It could be anyone watching you. So once you take those steps, make sure that you take those steps towards whatever you want and the goals that you want to accomplish in life. So I will be reading the first quote. So the first quote that I will be reading for you all today: self-belief must come first in your life in order to grow and believe in the goals you are able to achieve. Once you believe in those goals, you can accomplish anything. Look at me. We're here tonight. I believed in this goal, and I made it happen. When you are forced to make a drastic change in your life, know it happened for a reason, and move on to the next situation. Once something drastic happens, if you keep dwelling on it, it will continue to happen. Every time you think about that drastic thing that happened to you, it will drastically happen to you again. So we just gotta make sure that when things happen, we realize why it happened, we learn from it, and we keep moving on. And finally, I think we're inspired. Smile, regardless of your troubles. Remember, it could be worse, but we'll only get better. Okay, you guys, there's a lot of things that people are dealing with every day that are worse than our hair problems. So we gotta just keep in mind that, be thankful for what problems do arise, because we know we have the power to devour them, defeat them, and beat all of them. Moving on to stay inspired. And of course I chose quotes to keep up with the theme. Stay at peace with what's happening at the present time. Continue the journey of life with love and serenity. And love is the most important word in that stick in that quote right there. As long as we continue to keep love in our heart and do things with love, no matter what negative happens, positive will come right behind it. But you have to have love first. If you do things with hate or spite, you will never get anywhere in life. And I can definitely tell you that. All right. Once you allow positive thinking to enter your thoughts, think of all the positive things that will happen. Just imagine. It all starts with a thought. The thought is the belief. Once you start with the thought, that means you have the belief you can do that and you can accomplish it. So just know it all starts with that belief. Despite the view of others, shine your light on them with goodness. Because regardless of what others view or think of you, know that as long as you know you're good and you keep good in your heart and have good intentions, they may one day see it too. Now we're moving on to start inspiring others. Because that's what we fail to do a lot of us in life. Know that there are no mistakes and continue to trust in yourself. We have a tendency to always want to listen to other people, knowing that we know how we should handle or deal with the situations, we want to take advice from others. But we have to know, we have to trust ourselves first, because we will give ourselves the best advice that we can. When stressful times come and you get upset, listen to others so one day you too can become the voice of reason. You know, sometimes when it's an argument going or situations arise or things are happening around you, you may be unaware of how to handle it or how to speak on it. But if you're able to listen to the situation, you may find that answer within yourself. And last but not least, release your fear of communicating with others. You have a lot of information to share. And we fail to realize that we have to uplift and we have to share what we know and the knowledge that we've obtained in our years of living with others. It's something that you may know, someone else may need to know, and you may be that torch or that key spark what they need to know and need to do. So just keep in mind, you guys, that we once know that in life, you always have to help others. That's the most important thing. So I want to introduce, I'll play a little bit of music, but the next speaker will be Frederick Gracie. He will be coming up and speaking. He is a business owner. So he will be speaking to you guys today about being a business owner.